Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Gab Official. Today I'm going to be replacing a temperature sensor housing on this Vauxhall Mokka. As you can see, I'm going to be replacing this unit down here. As you can see, there's a pretty good way with a gearbox. But first, what you need to do is obviously drain the cooler out from underneath. And then obviously you can start removing the pipes to the housing. You also need to remove this intercooler part, as you can see that's in the way. So that's the first thing we're going to do. Get that out of the way. It's a 7mm socket. As you can see over there. Just going to remove that first. Make sure you just tuck this pipe out of the way. And then see temperature sensor housing. As you can see, what I mean temperature sensor housing, the cooler temperature sensor housing. As you can see, this is the new one. So that's what we're going to fit back on. As you can see, 7mm. Thank you. centre away from it. There's the detail socket, slot socket.
Okay, now release that bolt spot.
Okay.
It should just come on.
As you can see, disconnect the O2 sensor plug of the actual coolant temperature sensor housing. Literally, it's like a little clip at the bottom of it that you need to push in, and then you just slide this down, it comes straight off. As you can see, then you can just slot it straight back on. As you can see, it's got the little bruise where it sits inside of it. Putting it back on, just slide it back on, punch it and all that. That's also another way. You can literally just take the whole clip out from the side there. It's two little prongs, you just push it in and pop it forward. But obviously, there's a little bit of space on this, that's a little trick to take it. And then let's take the housing off first before we do that. Now, what you do is, you disconnect the just sensor plug. Just sort of plug and push it in, pull it off. Simple as. Now things out of the way. We're going to use an E10 style socket just to remove those three bolts. We're going to take it off, clean up the area, put the new one, put the new coolant in there, and leave the system. See, now we're going to take the bolts off. Take that out. You see it's leaking around the block from where the seal was. I'm going to fit a new one. That's what we're going to just clean the area up. Don't do anything. You can see, just going to use a little bit of this sandpaper, just to, or Henry paper, whatever they call it, just to clean up the area there. So that new seal sits flush, as you can see. The area is all clean now. We've got a new one to be installed on it. You can fit that. As you can see, the new one is now fit back on. I just need to just untie the screws to make sure they're not going to any of them. And then I'm going to go tighten them and torque them and get the clamps back on those pipes and then use it in the center. As you can see, that's actually what I was talking about when I closed the O2 central plug. Push those two bits in, as you can see, it slips straight up. Now, I'm just going to plug the sensor back in. here. And it's going to include the part that will set up this blank point in the main one. And put this one back home. You see. And then put this part back in here. Keeping it in there. See, snap back together. I'm now going to fit the overflow pipe. As you can see, this is a blanking off plug. It's got a new seal on there. I'm going to fit it onto this one. I'm going to reuse the whole seal on there. So I'm going to put this one on there. See, that's in. It's not coming out. Now I'm going to refit this empty cooler pipe. So it's part of the system. As you can see, that part there, you can squeeze that to let it retract there. Out of it. And also, so, there, there, there. That's the part. See that plug there, just loosen the plug out. Make sure we're filling it out, we'll stop seeing the bubbles and stuff coming out of it. Until that's okay. Tighten it back up, leave the car to run for so probably a half hour until the fan kicks in. Then literally leave it to set for like an hour, check the level, the level is dropped, just top it up, and that's it. As you can see, you see the little bubbles coming out of it whilst the engine's running, so I'm going to do it sliding off. Shut it, put the lid on the bowl, and just run it through the water to get the temperature.
Thank you. Thank you for watching. Get official. Please like and subscribe for further content on my channel. This will help me out.